Hi, I'm Brett.
I'm Amber.
And we just wanted to thank you so much for coming out and celebrating with us.
Here's a little bit about our story.
You must have been a beautiful baby. You must have been a wonderful child. When you were only starting to go to kindergarten, I bet you drove the little boys wild. And when it came to winning blue ribbons, you must have shown the other kids how. I can see the judges' eyes as they handed you the prize. I bet you made the cutest bow. Oh, you must have been a beautiful baby, 'cause baby, look at you now. Does your mother realize the stork delivered quite a prize the day he left you on the family tree? Does your dad appreciate that you're merely super great, the miracle of any century? If they don't, just send them both to me.
Well, we met in Lakeside, Montana at a discipleship mission school called YWAM, Youth with a Mission. That's where I met Brett. I remember hearing Brett before I saw him. We were in a circle and I heard him talking and he just sounded really insightful. And so I was like, oh, that sounds like a cool guy, but I couldn't see him because there were too many people in the way. But I finally saw him and I met him and we became really good friends.
First time I remember meeting Amber, she just seemed like really a cool person and I wanted to get to meet her and I'm so happy that I did and it definitely changed my life. So that's when we started being friends, and we went on the same missions team to Argentina. We were both in Argentina for like 3 months, and it was a really great time for us, and we grew a lot, and we got to know each other better, and we were friends all throughout that. We both liked each other at different points, but...
But we never said anything.
Yeah.
I didn't know you liked me.
Yeah, I don't know. It just didn't seem very plausible at the time.
Yeah, I remember I liked Brett, and then I thought, I'm never going to see him again, he lives in Oklahoma. So, I mean, we went through the school, and we were really good friends, and I went back to Hawaii, and he kept calling me and texting me. And I was like, okay, I guess this guy's interested or something. And that summer, I got to go and visit a bunch of friends all across the U.S., California, and Texas, and so I also stopped by Oklahoma and got to visit Brett, and I got to know his family, and I stayed with them for a little bit, and yeah, that's when I really, really started to like Brett and hope that there was a future there.
Yeah, and that's when, I mean, I knew that I liked Amber, but I wasn't, whenever she came to visit in Oklahoma, I was like, okay, I'm serious about this girl, and I really like her, and I want to invest in our future together, and I definitely felt like she could be the girl that I would end up marrying. So she flew back to Hawaii after visiting. I just felt very uneasy and very kind of unrested, and so I prayed about it, and I felt like I was supposed to move to Hawaii. So I sold my motorcycle, and I bought a plane ticket one way, and I flew out to Hawaii after getting her parents' permission, of course, to come out.
It was really important that he got to know my family and that he got to know where I'm from and just my culture and my life. And so that meant a lot. And I think it was at that point when I realized, wow, this is serious. God just seemed to continue to open the doors for us and especially to give us opportunities to take leaps of faith because, I mean, sometimes we didn't know what do I do next? And it just seemed like that was the next option. And
yeah.
So Brett was in Hawaii for about 9 months, and then he decided to come back to Tulsa to start school. And I had been wanting to go to the mainland as well. And finally I decided, okay, I'm going to move to Tulsa. So I moved and I found a job, and now I'm a teacher there. Things just really seem to line up in place.
Since she's moved to Tulsa, we've both become way more settled, and we're definitely matured a lot in our relationship, and yeah, it's just been such a great time in just the journey that we've gone through together, and I'm so excited for this big step and all the other adventures that we're gonna have that are ahead of us and for our future.
So it's just been incredible to be able to come home to Hawaii and get married here. We are going to be living in Tulsa for at least another year. But before that, we're going to go on a honeymoon to Iceland.
We'll be staying there for a couple days, and we'll spend New Year's there and then fly back to the States on New Year's Day.
But I'm sure we will be back in Hawaii every once in a while because we can't stay away.
Yeah.
So